Welcome back. Markets are holding their own, you will have to say, despite negative cues from Wall Street and Asia. Indian markets down just 0.2, and that too only for the heavies, the Nifty and the Sensex. The mid caps are actually a shade of green, and the small caps up 0.33%. Let's get talking about more fundamental issues, and a company which reflects many of the issues that confront the economy is Tata Power. Joining us now is Anil Sardana, Managing Director, Tata Power. Good morning, Mr. Sardana. Thank you very much for finding the time for us. Well, first up, has the CERC told you when is the final order? We understand it's in 2 weeks. Is that correct?
Well, they have not indicated a firm schedule. Good morning, Lata. CERC has finished the hearings, and MERC has just submitted their affidavit about a few days back, on 26th to be precise. And now they have given time for us to file an affidavit, giving our rejoinder on that affidavit. And after that, perhaps they will take another 2 to 3 weeks. So I'm hoping that by end of December, we could hope for the order.
Okay. Well, let me come to what we heard in terms of the affidavits filed by the SEBs themselves, Maharashtra and Haryana, the ones in question. We understand that they have in return asked for the right to terminate the PPA without any compensation. Is that true? And if that is indeed one of the conditions they put forward to you getting that compensatory tariff, would that seriously affect your fortunes?
Well, I think it's been quite misunderstood. The clause that you're particularly referring to is actually a very, very genuine clause from their side, I would suggest. What they've actually expressed is that, assume that tomorrow the dollar fluctuation makes the dollar go to a very unviable number, and similarly if the coal gets to, say, unviable number like $150 or $200 to a ton, what they've said is that if this power becomes uncompetitive compared to other sources that they have to their disposal, then they shouldn't be paying us the compensatory tariffs. They should rather be allowed to reset back. I think that's a very fair ask from their side, for the simple reason that today the basic point that we have all been making is that despite compensatory tariff, this would be one of the most competitive power that they will be able to source. Now if that is the case, how can we just simply expect that they will have to pay the compensatory tariff even if this becomes completely out of the whack? So I think it's a very fair ask from their side, and to that extent, I completely endorse that thought.
Okay. Mr. Sardana, I'll come back to this in a bit, but before that, just one word on the compensatory tariff amount itself. It has been recommended at about 50 paise, but I wanted to ask you, at how much of a tariff hike will you be able to incur either a cash profit or completely recover all of your fixed costs?
There are two components, as we know, of the tariff, two prime components. One is the variable cost, which is the fuel part, and the other is the fixed cost. And the as far as the variable cost, that's the prayer right now. We have requested for the variable cost to become a pass-through because of the changes that happened in the globe. As far as the fixed cost is concerned, there too now we have new challenges, particularly because of the dollar exchange variation. Now what has happened is that, if you recall, we completed the project at a very competitive fixed cost. But in terms of mark to market, and with the dollar having fluctuated to a point where it's upwards of 62 rupees today to a dollar, our price continues to fluctuate, our fixed cost continues to fluctuate. In other words, it's reflecting basically the amount that we have to pay in terms of interest as well as the principal. Well, our interest is hedged, though of course at a cost. The principal, there are no tools available today in the market, as we all know, which will be able to hedge it for periods beyond, say, 3-4 years, because the banks themselves are very wary of where this rupee exchange could go. Considering this situation and the fact what we see, we also now have a challenge of about 13 to 15 paisa in the fixed cost. So coming back to your question that you asked, as far as the variable price is concerned, with the compensatory tariff of about 45-50 paisa, which is what will come through, we should be able to make sure that there is no loss in the variable price. But we will have a challenge of making a return in the fixed cost, because whatever returns we had envisaged, that's getting wiped out today because of the change in the rupee exchange rate.
Okay. Mr. Sardana, like Sonia, I'll come back to the SEB and the PPA issue, but since you started off on that dollar loan, your dollar payments are back ended. Have you been able to reschedule your loan itself? It's 30%, right, of your total debt. Have you been able to reschedule it?
See, today Tata Power's dollar exposure is something like $1.2 billion. That's the total kitty that we have, and the challenge, as I keep saying, whatever be the term for the payment of the principal, the biggest issue is that you're not able to hedge the exposure. And the challenge is that still being very competitive loan, imagine we got it at time when it was very, very low, and even till today with all costs put together is still close to 10.5-11% as is determined in the Indian rupee terms. So it's very competitive, and therefore one doesn't really want to talk about restructuring it. One can look at eventual opportunities to harmonize some of our debt once we have compensated tariff order. But as far as return of loan or any other swapping is concerned, that will actually make our cost of funds much more expensive. So we are therefore wanting to stay put in the manner that we have conceptualized.
Okay, let me just finish that compensatory tariff point that you were speaking with Sonia. You said that the compensatory tariff is really a pass through. Does it mean that it is 45 paise now, but if for a different coal price and a different dollar rupee rate, this compensatory tariff could increase? Is that the negotiation?
Well said. No, that's not really the negotiation. If I take you back to what the bidding norms were, we had bid this in dollar terms. And therefore, to that extent, once it is restored back to the concept that it will be passed through, and it automatically gets compensated for the dollar. It also then gets compensated for the change in law as well as the discount, which has now sort of been prevented by the change in law. So it restores back that aspect on which we have no control, and therefore there is absolutely no expectation for loss there in the compensatory tariff.
Okay. Another issue that investors have really been worried about is the continuous losses that you've seen in your Mundra power plant, and there are some estimates which are doing the rounds of about 1200 to 2600 crores per annum in terms of a cash loss that you might see. Can you just give us an indication of whether that will actually pan out, and for how long do you think the pain would continue there?
Well, Sonia, as long as the compensated tariff doesn't come, we will continue to have that 45-50 paisa per unit loss that we talked about. And if you take account of that, it automatically comes to that figure that you mentioned about 1200 to 1500 crore loss today. It could have been 2600 crore if we had not taken steps to blend the coal, or not taken steps to get distressed coal from Colombia or from US, which today we are able to off and on get to some parcels because of the present situation, and therefore we have been able to contain some of those loss. And while our prayer is to sort of compensate us from the day when we commission the unit, we will have to wait for the order to come in and see as to what exactly has been accepted against our prayers.
Okay. Well, we understand the SEBs have put in two other conditions. One, that they don't want it with retrospective effect. They want the hike, if any, from on a prospective basis. Also, they will not be penalized for not procuring power. Your reactions, will that lead you too much?
Lata, the first part they certainly have indicated that against our prayer, where we have said it should be retrospective, and we have said retrospective in actual. We have not said that retrospective based on normative basis. So if we have contained the loss by our effort, we are wanting to pass that advantage to them. We have also said that whatever gain we have in the coal side in Indonesia because of our investments there, we are willing to even use that to sort of negate any increase that will happen, and compensatory tariff should include whatever gains that we have had in the Indonesian side. On the second part that you have mentioned, there is no such aspect in the request that the beneficiaries have made. So could you elaborate if you have some different understanding?
No, we were told that they said they don't want to pay penalties if they didn't procure the power. But I think that ties in with the right to terminate as well. If the cost is beyond them, then they will not procure, and therefore they should not be penalized for not procuring.
Yeah, I think we need to understand from customers and consumers' perspective that ultimately the cost of Mundra today is one of the most competitive one, and we have shown that and displayed that. That even addition of this compensated tariff, it will be close to about 3 rupees or slightly below 3 rupees. Now, today if you look at what these very DISCOMs are buying, it's buying much more power beyond 3 rupees. Now, assume tomorrow situation changes, the compensated tariff demands them to pay 4, 4.5. The assumption is that the domestic power and the other sources of power will not increase in the similar terms, which also is expected to be, you know, a fictitious or a hypothetical situation. If we assume that internationally the coal prices will move to $150, and if you assume that dollar rupee dollar conversion will move to very unfavorable terms, there is all likelihood that even the Indian coal prices and the other sources of power will increase.
All right, Mr. Sardana, we'll have to leave it at that. Sorry, we've run out of time completely, but we will touch base with you again at the end of the month when there is more clarity on the CERC order. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us your views. But let's get another guest in now, an important voice at that. Jonathan Garner, the Managing Director of Morgan Stanley, joins us.